Buongiorno and happy Columbus Day. My name is Anthony Naccarato, and I'm state president of the Grand Lodge of New York, Order of Sons and Daughters of Italy in America, a national fraternal and philanthropic organization. My parents and five siblings immigrated to America, arriving in the port of New York, aboard the ship Vulcania, and I was touched by the significance of the Statue of Liberty on October 3, 1955. I was 9 years old. Our first American residence was in Brownsville, Brooklyn. Our nuclear family was reunited with my mother's parents and her sister. My grandfather, Franco, came to America in 1933, and due to a variety of circumstances, my grandmother, Concetta, and my grandfather were apart until 1949, until she and my aunt were able to come to America. It was another 6 years until my mother's family was completely reunited. As memorable as our Vulcania voyage was, the most important, exciting event occurred along the way in the port of Genoa, where my father took me to visit the house where Christopher Columbus had lived. This remains vivid to me all these years later. Here I was in the old home of the man who had discovered the land that soon would be my family's new home. The tour was fascinating to begin with, but my father, a wonderful storyteller with a gift for detail, made it even more magical to this 9-year-old boy who'd never been to a large city, who was walking around in the home of a heroic explorer who will live forever in the hearts of all Italians. More than that, even at a such tender age, I clearly understood the importance of what Christopher Columbus, through his daring and sheer perseverance, had contributed to the advancement of knowledge to the entire world. Neil deGrasse Tyson, the celebrated astrophysicist, cosmologist, planetary scientist and author recently said in a radio interview that Columbus' discovery of America was the most significant thing that had happened to our species. Furthermore, he stated that Columbus discovering the Americas was a great achievement that joined two human species from Europe and the Americas. His book, Astrophysics for People in a Hurry, was on the New York Times bestseller list for 67 weeks. After all these years, I've had the distinct pleasure of visiting his home and having read and studied a variety of historical documents about his life. I am proud to say that I remain extremely devoted to Christopher Columbus, not only because he was a magnificent explorer, but because he was a devout and God-fearing person. He truly deserved the singular title of Admiral of the Ocean Seas for his character, indomitable spirit, and intrepid courage. Ciao, and congratulations to Grand Marshal Governor Andrew Cuomo and distinguished honoree Dr. Anthony Fauci. And remember, oggi siamo tutti italiani. Today, we're all Italians. Happy Columbus Day.